Looking for an interesting, vibrant, but laid-back destination? Somewhere that will allow you to relax, enjoy the outdoors? A place where you have a wide selection of world-class restaurants and hotels to choose from? Then Cape Town is the ideal destination for you. Spoil yourself by surrounding yourself with the natural beauty of this city. Cape Town is one of the few cities in the world where people come to get away from it all. Celebrities, models, the rich and famous, and us normal folk all flock here to relax, kick back, and enjoy Cape Town's exceptional diversity on its long summer days. So for those of you who have already bought your ticket, start getting excited. And for those of you who haven't, here's what you're missing out on. Situated on the southeastern tip of Africa, at the foot of the iconic Table Mountain, Cape Town is known as one of the world's most beautiful cities. And it's easy to see why Sir Francis Drake, when he circumnavigated the globe, described it as the fairest cape of them all. The city is a melting pot, where east meets west in Africa, and the resulting blend is a fascinating mix of cultures and history. This diversity is easily seen in the faces of the people, their languages, food, and architecture. The Mother City, as she is fondly known, offers a wonderful lifestyle and diverse range of activities and attractions. Locals will tell you that you need at least a month to explore their beautiful region, but you can get a good feel for Cape Town in as little as 2 or 3 busy days. But be warned, once you have visited this vibrant city, you'll be back again and again. Coming to Africa to spot the Big Five, the elephant, rhino, buffalo, leopard and lion, ranks highly on many visitors' to-do list. Well, in Cape Town, we have the Big Six, the city's top 6 tourist attractions. And they're all definitely worth a visit. The breathtaking Table Mountain, a lazy day sampling world-class food and wine in the beautiful winelands. The emotional trip out to Robben Island. The V&A waterfront, with its vibrant retail and entertainment areas for locals and tourists alike. The trip to and from Cape Point, which has few international rivals and boasts some of the Cape's best seaside restaurants. And last but not least is the Kirstenbosch Botanical Gardens on the slopes of Table Mountain, a wonderful showcase of the unique diversity of South Africa's flora, especially the world-renowned Cape Floral Kingdom. And it's not just the Big Six, but so much more. From soaking up the sun on one of the beautiful beaches, to going head-to-head with a great white shark. And, of course, everything in between. Few cities in the world are blessed with such scenery and diversity, with a combination of sea and mountains providing an almost unparalleled outdoor playground. We hope to see you in Cape Town soon. As the oldest city in South Africa, Cape Town is steeped in history. And as a visitor here, you'll uncover some fascinating stories, legends, and facts as you visit her monuments and places of interest. The Cape was first rounded by the Portuguese mariner Bartolomeu Dias in 1488. But the Portuguese made no attempt to settle here, rather settling in modern-day Mozambique, where there were better natural harbors. Cape Town began as a supply outpost for the ships of the Dutch East India Company, roughly halfway along their lucrative spice route to the east, and as was often the case in colonial enterprises, where private individuals had led the way, the government soon followed. When the Dutch arrived in the Cape, it was inhabited by the Khoikhoi and Khoisan, nomadic pastoralists and hunter-gatherers respectively, and referred to as Hottentots and Bushmen by the settlers. A fort and gardens, the remnants of which can still be seen today, were established at the foot of Table Mountain, and land was granted to settlers to grow crops. Being free, nomadic, and living off the land, the local inhabitants were reluctant to work for the Dutch, so they had to import slaves from the east to provide the labor. Along with the other immigrants, these slaves have left an indelible mark on the faces, culture, architecture, language, and cuisine of the city. Cape Town enjoys a mild Mediterranean climate, with long, dry summers and the majority of the rains falling in the winter months, a boon for people wishing to escape the northern winter. The summer months from November to April are generally dry and hot, with plenty of sun to bathe in on Cape Town's beautiful beaches, and are thus the most popular time to visit. During the period from the 16th of December to the 16th of January, foreign tourists and South Africans alike descend on the city, and this is when the city really rocks. A great time to visit if you're looking to have a lot of fun. In order to avoid disappointment, it is important to book well in advance if you wish to visit Cape Town during the holiday season. Cape Town has a reputation for being a summer destination. However, this is only true for those wanting a beach holiday. The winter is significantly cooler, and it is when we get our rain. But the clear, calm, cloudless winter days are wonderful. This is also the time of year that breeding whales visit our shores. And with the first hint of spring, the legendary West Coast flowers bloom, transforming the sparsely vegetated countryside overnight. Almost every tourist activity continues through the winter. And as there are fewer tourists in town, the popular places are easier to get into and often more enjoyable. Although the Cape gets winter rains, the rest of the country does not and enjoys wonderful mild winters. This is the best time to go on a wildlife safari, as water is scarce and the vegetation is less lush, making it easier to spot the game. So don't be put off by our winter. The Cape still has plenty to offer. A great way to get your bearings and discover Cape Town is to jump on board the red topless buses, which have two routes covering the city and part of the peninsula, taking you to interesting local attractions such as the castle, Table Mountain, the waterfront and Hout Bay, a quaint fishing village to the south of Cape Town. Car rentals are easy to find and plentiful. All you need is a valid driver's license. And most companies will drop off and collect your car from your hotel, or you can hire a car at the airport on arrival. A car will give you the freedom to discover Cape Town and the surrounds at your own pace and in your own time. And car navigators with GPS audio commentary can be rented at the airport, not only helping you to get where you want to be, but providing you with information and stories along the way. But don't forget, we drive on the left. The Big Six are essentially the must-dos of Cape Town. They cover a wide range of interests, and we recommend that first-time visitors focus on them and see the highlights of Cape Town. The first thing you should do is take a trip up Table Mountain in the cable car, and within minutes you will reach the summit with its superb 360-degree view of the city and the entire peninsula. If the cable car is open, go, because if the wind picks up, they have to close. And if you're still up there in the early evening, you might be lucky enough to experience a spectacular sunset. From the viewing decks of Table Mountain, you can see all but one of the other Big Six. Below you is the city, and on the foreshore you can clearly see the vibrant Victoria and Alfred waterfront, South Africa's number one tourist attraction, and a major shopping and entertainment center for Capetonians and visitors. Much of the waterfront's charm is that it is set in a busy commercial harbour against the backdrop of the city and Table Mountain. Enjoy its Aladdin's Cave of jewellery shops, speciality clothing arcades, craft markets and dining venues. And aside from the vast array of shops stylistically incorporated into old warehouses and heritage buildings, there is plenty of entertainment on offer, including ferry trips around the harbour and helicopter flips which cover the entire peninsula. It is from the clock tower area of the waterfront that you can catch the ferry out to the World Heritage Site of Robben Island. Across the city and its northern suburbs are the Hottentots Holland Mountains. Below and beyond them lie the Cape Winelands, arguably the most scenic wine region in the world. Mountains, vineyards, old Cape Dutch architecture, and some of the country's best restaurants all blend to create a wonderful wine route experience. And talking of routes, few compare with the splendor of the Cape coastline on the drive down to Cape Point and back. The beautiful, secluded beaches are enhanced by the fact that the ridge of Table Mountain continues all the way along the spine of the peninsula, and in places, the road winds along precipitous cliffs. And being a peninsula, you can drive along different coasts, there and back, each with its own sea view, restaurants, character, and secrets. Cape Point is where the cold Benguela Current meets the warm Agulhas Current, and you can walk up to the old lighthouse, breathing in some of the freshest air on the planet, as there is nothing between you and the next landmass, the Antarctic, 4,000 kilometers to the south. As you drive all over the Cape, you will be surrounded by the fynbos of the Cape Floral Kingdom. Table Mountain is famous for its floral diversity, with more than 1,500 plant species, many of which aren't found anywhere else in the world. And on the slopes of the mountain is the unique Kirstenbosch Botanical Gardens, which is considered one of the 7 magnificent botanical gardens of the world. Kirstenbosch only grows plants that are indigenous to South Africa, and it is a showcase for the fynbos of the Cape. The gardens also have extensive lawns with breathtaking views of the mountain. And on Sunday evenings in summer, Capetonians and visitors gather with picnics to listen to local and international artists performing in open-air concerts on the lawns. If history and culture interest you, Cape Town has much to offer. A wealth of museums and art galleries are at your disposal, documenting her interesting past, and will help you get a feel for the historical and cultural diversity of Cape Town. Until relatively recently, the culture, religion, and food of the Cape were dominated by San, European, and Eastern influences. But since the collapse of apartheid, the city has definitely become more African. From the street names, monuments, and statues, you can tell that Europe has been the dominant influence over the past 300 years. But even Cape Town is starting to lose the feeling of being a little bit of Europe on the southern tip of Africa. The city is a melting pot of East, West, and Africa, and as a result, there is a great diversity of museums, so follow your interests. If it's colonial or apartheid, visit the Slave Lodge, Robben Island, the Boerkaap, and District 6. For the European influence, the Castle, Rhodes Memorial, and the Jewish Museum provide fascinating insights. The people who are unique to the Cape are, of course, the Cape Coloureds. Their genetic mix and culture being totally homegrown and a function of the Cape's history. In the colorful Boerkaap on the edge of the city, you can see where the descendants of Indonesian slaves brought to the Cape in the 17th and 18th centuries have blended their cultural identity and Islamic creed. To get an insight into the modern dynamic, a visit to Green Market Square in the middle of the town exposes the extent to which Africans from the north have migrated south in recent years. If you listen, you will discover that lingua franca is French, the language that the West and Central Africans have in common. And a cultural trip to Cape Town would not be complete without a visit to the townships of the Cape Flats, for that is where most Capetonians live today. Undoubtedly, the best way to experience this is to take an organized tour, which will give you a chance to experience the energy and the warmth of the communities in the townships. You can't help but get caught up in the vigor of township life, its markets, shebeens, and spaza shops. And you will also gain an insight into Ubuntu, the African cultural philosophy of I exist because you exist. A popular way to relax on holiday is to spend a day on the beach, and Cape Town has plenty of exquisite beaches. You can choose from the trendy Atlantic side, where the beaches are flanked by the homes of the rich and famous and some of Cape Town's top hotels and restaurants, or the somewhat warmer, family-friendly beaches on the Indian Ocean side. Restaurants and cafes abound on Cape Town's endless coastline, and you'll be spoilt for choice for a long, lazy lunch with a beautiful view of the sea while time stands still. And as relaxing is a trip out to the restaurants of the winelands where, as Capetonians say, you can just chill, bro. Capetonians have a great sense of occasion, and it's a tradition to bid farewell to yet another beautiful day with a sundowner. There are hundreds of locations from which to choose: Table Mountain, Signal Hill, or the numerous beach bars which ply their trade with views of the Atlantic Ocean. To take it to another level, you can go on a cruise where your skipper will drop anchor just beyond the breakers while you sip on champagne, watching the sun slip below the horizon. Ah, the good life. And if even your relaxation hasn't washed your stress away, well, don't forget a visit to one of Cape Town's numerous spas. Cape Town is situated on a long, thin peninsula with a mountain range running down its spine, creating the ultimate playground for outdoor and water sport enthusiasts. For mountain bikers and hiking enthusiasts, Cape Town is a paradise. You can choose from a wide selection of routes that will take you to Table Mountain, forests, nature reserves, and winelands, all within a stone's throw of the city. For water sports that blend with wind, Cape Town is an international mecca with world-class windsurfing, kiteboarding, and sailing on offer. The beautiful coastline makes it ideal for kayaking, canoeing, jet skiing, snorkeling, and scuba diving. While if you're a surfer, you're almost always able to find a wave somewhere along the peninsula. The landscape provides beautiful, challenging golf courses, and golf lovers are spoilt for choice. Local clubs extend a warm welcome to tourists, and you're able to hire a set of clubs and a cart. As Cape Town continues to develop as a leading tourist destination, more and more wonderful activities present themselves. So why not take in the splendor of the peninsula on a rented Harley, or gallop a horse along the flats of Noordhoek Beach? Cape Town has no shortage of activities for adrenaline junkies. A unique and very popular activity is being able to go face to face with a great white and come out alive. Other opportunities to frighten yourself include skydiving, paragliding, rock climbing, and abseiling. For a large city, Cape Town has a surprising array of activities on its doorstep that allow you to get close to nature. On a trip to Cape Point, you can visit a bird and monkey sanctuary, a seal colony, an ostrich farm, see the antelope in the Cape Point Nature Reserve, have a close encounter with baboons, share the beach with the penguins at Boulders, and between July and October, see whales close to shore. In the winelands just out of Cape Town, you will find a cheetah and lion sanctuary and an internationally renowned butterfly farm. You can head off to a game farm for a day trip. These are not to the standard of the game reserves found elsewhere in the country. However, if this is your only opportunity to see Africa's wild animals, it is certainly worth the trip. And don't forget the fynbos on the mountain, and the incredible vistas and invigorating hikes one can enjoy while wandering through this phenomenal biodiversity. Cape Town provides many exciting and varied shopping experiences for those in need of a bit of retail therapy. The waterfront provides you with the opportunity to shop for well-known local and foreign clothing brands, and is full of specialized shops selling jewelry, souvenirs, African curios, and wines. In keeping with their philosophy of the waterfront being for everybody, not just those looking for Gucci, there are two old warehouses which now sell a fascinating array of locally made trinkets and clothes. During the week, Green Market Square and the surrounding area are the best places to purchase souvenirs, African curios, arts and crafts. The traders and shop owners are from all over Africa, and you're able to wander around looking at the interesting bits and pieces. And as far as the prices go, what you see is not necessarily what you have to pay. And when Green Market Square closes on Sundays, the traders move to the Greenpoint Market near that new 2010 FIFA World Cup stadium, which offers a bigger, more variable version of the same. Or, as we say here, same same but different. With South Africa being the biggest producer of gold and diamonds, it is not surprising that many tourists like to purchase jewelry here, and the fact that it's cheaper here might have something to do with this. There are many jewelers in Cape Town, but the Gold Museum and Jewel Africa Museum provide a history, show you how jewelry is made, and, surprise, surprise, sell jewelry too. There are also many small specialized shopping precincts like Kloof Street and the Cape Quarter, which might be of interest to you. The Smart Guide Cape Town Shopping Guide gives you personalized information as to where to find what and recommends interesting and unique shopping experiences. The illustration of Cape Town being a melting pot of cultures is well reflected in the food. Not only does Cape Town boast a wide range of restaurants, Thai, Greek, Italian, French and German, mostly run by natives of those countries, but its local cuisine, a unique fusion of African, Eastern and European ingredients, is a must. Babuti, Cook Sisters, Biltong, Melktaart, Briedi, these names might sound strange, but they are some of the culinary delights that await you in the Cape. And don't forget the seafood. The Cape has a wealth of excellent seafood restaurants, which offer freshly caught and prepared fish and shellfish. So if you're a foodie, you can look forward to being spoilt for choice. Cape Town has always had great restaurants, but now they are truly becoming world class. In the winelands, less than an hour away, you will find Franschhoek, where the French Huguenots settled in the 1700s. This is the country's gourmet capital and boasts numerous restaurants that have won international acclaim, always getting two or three in South Africa's top 10. With the natural beauty of the Cape, there are numerous venues with wonderful settings, beach, winelands, mountains, all of which are perfect for long, lazy lunches. When the sun goes down in Cape Town, it's time to crank up the volume. You'll find a wide choice of nightlife on offer, from theatres and bars to restaurants and clubs that cater for a variety of tastes. There are a number of theatres which offer a wide selection of excellent local productions, from ballet and jazz to stand-up comedy. Most restaurants stay open until about midnight, and bars stay open until late, while clubs usually get going at about 11 p.m. and offer live bands and a variety of music. If you're feeling lucky, you might want to visit Grand West Casino, which stays open all night and with loads of tables and slot machines will transport you to a 24-hour world of restaurants, clubs and pubs. Although it's quite possible to spend your whole holiday in Cape Town, there is plenty on offer in its surrounding areas and the rest of South Africa. And most tourists visit two or three destinations during a two-week stay. The Winelands is a wonderful place to relax and indulge yourself. And although most first-time visitors to Cape Town visit it for a day, we would recommend spending a night or two in the region if you want to really get a feel for it. Most self-drive tourists visiting South Africa start their trip in Cape Town and then make their way along the southern Cape coast to the Garden Route. This is a quick and easy drive. For backpackers, a hop-on, hop-off bus operates up and down the route. If you have the time, we would recommend that you take Route 62, an inland route winding through the mountains, passing the sleepy towns of the Klein Karoo, which have remained unchanged and kept their charm. The Garden Route is a lush stretch of coastline that is framed by the ocean to the south and mountains to the north. It has wonderful natural beauty with breathtaking lagoons, beaches, and vegetation, with almost every imaginable tourist and water sport activity on offer. It is also South Africa's golfing mecca, with the most scenic and highly rated courses on almost every corner. From the Garden Route, self-drive tourists generally fly to the Kruger National Park for their game experience. Or alternatively, drive through to Port Elizabeth and onto the Eastern Cape Game Reserves. The Kruger National Park and the surrounding private game reserves make up the premier game viewing area in the country. But the Eastern Cape offers a good experience and generally better value. When planning a multi-destination trip to South Africa, we suggest that you contact a tour operator, as although the connections are very simple when they work, the person putting your trip together should understand the size and the intricacies of travel in South Africa. They're also probably able to get you better deals than can be sourced on the internet. So instead of searching for your own accommodation, rather find a few tour operators, brief them on your requirements, and let them come up with some suggestions, and select the tour operator you feel most comfortable with.